If you're new to the real estate industry and haven't gone through the interview process before, you might be surprised when you actually get into it how long this process can end up being. An application followed by a phone screening, and then a phone interview with a hiring manager, an in-person interview, an Excel-based technical assessment, and a final round interview with the firm's executive leadership team isn't uncommon at all in the CRE hiring process, and all of these steps together can end up spanning several months from the time you submit your application to the time you receive an offer. And although this entire process isn't easy, one of the biggest wild cards that can be thrown your way is the last step of this, and that is the final round interview with the firm's senior leadership team, where the questions you'll need to tackle might look a little bit different than the first few interviews you had with other members of the firm. So in this video, to help you get across the finish line successfully, what we'll do is zoom in on the last part of the real estate hiring process, the final round interview, and walk through three of the biggest things you can do to ace your final round at a real estate investment, brokerage, or lending firm to land the job you're looking for. So in the real estate industry, the interview process can be difficult, time-consuming, and overall really, really tiring for a few months. Between traveling to interviews, taking time off from your current job to interview during the day, and preparing for technical exams, each step of the process can be pretty taxing in itself, and the last thing you want to do is have to start over after getting to the final stage of the game. So to try and save you from that pain, this week's video is my attempt to prevent that from happening to you and the three biggest things I'd recommend if you came to me looking for advice on how to prep for a final round interview in the real estate industry. So first, and really above anything else on this list, to prepare for a final round interview, the first thing I'd recommend is getting very, very clear on your answer to the question, where do you see yourself 5 years from now? When you're interviewing with senior executives who are primarily responsible for the direction of the company and the long-term strategic vision of their firm, their questions for you at this stage of the game are going to be used to figure out how well you fit within the firm and your long-term potential as a leader within the organization. I've said this many times on this channel, but hiring is expensive for companies, and as time-consuming as the interview process is for you as a job candidate, this process is even more time-consuming and resource-intensive for the companies actually doing the hiring. And because of that, from the perspective of a senior executive trying to maximize the firm's bottom line, the most beneficial scenario for the company's long-term growth when hiring new talent is to bring on committed, driven, passionate people that have the potential to grow internally within the company and can take on a leadership position in the future as well. The more often employees are promoted within the company itself, the less time and money that company has to spend on hiring new employees, and the more intellectual capital and relationship capital the company keeps long term. So for you as a job candidate, this means that your job in this final round interview is to convey to the company's leadership team that you are that person that can be that long-term solution that grows within the company, and that you have everything that it takes to become a leader in the firm as you continue to progress throughout your career. And to do that, this is your opportunity to talk through specifically why you believe in what the company is doing, what you think about their investment strategy and the product types or markets they have a presence in, and how your personal goals and interests align with what the firm is doing long term. The more you can show your commitment to the specific part of the industry the company exists within, and your desire to not only help out your own career, but to help the company grow and accelerate the initiatives they're already taking on, the more competitive you're going to be at this stage of the process. Now, aside from getting clear on the long-term vision for your career, the next thing on this list I'd recommend doing to prepare for a final round interview at a real estate firm is to research the company as much as you can and come prepared to talk through that research if necessary. At this stage of the interview process, one commonly asked question you'll see is some variation of why our company? And essentially, what you're being asked here is, what do you know about our firm? How do you fit in with our culture here? And what is unique about you that can help us achieve what we're trying to accomplish? Today, almost all real estate firms have some sort of a digital presence. So a layup here is digging into the company's website and also searching for external articles and press releases about new property acquisitions, new funds being raised, or key hires that mark a commitment to expansion in a certain region or property type. Companies know that if you're interviewing for a job at their firm, that's probably not the only job application that you fired off over the last few months. So they want to make sure that you're serious about their company specifically, rather than just looking for any new firm that will get you out of your current role. So to demonstrate your genuine interest and desire to work for this company specifically, take the time before talking to the executive team to dig in as much as you can into the company's website, news articles referencing the firm, any LinkedIn posts from senior leadership, or even the company's stock price over time if you're interviewing at a public investment firm or REIT. And this gives you the opportunity to find patterns in the company's actions and to think through how your own experiences, existing skill sets, and long-term goals align with the role you're applying for and the long-term trajectory of where the company is headed. Remember, during the interview process, and especially in the eyes of senior executives, you're being evaluated based on what you can do for the firm and how you can advance their objectives and where they're looking to go. And the more you know about that direction, the more clearly you can speak to how you can add value and help accelerate the process of taking that company closer to where they want to be long term. Now, finally, as a last point on this list, aside from digging into the company itself and getting clear on your own long-term goals, the final thing I'd recommend at this stage of the process is to prepare to be able to bring your critical thinking skills to the table. Like we talked about earlier on in this video, at this stage of the game, you've probably already gone through an Excel modeling assessment, your hiring manager has likely signed off on you as a candidate, and there's some pretty solid confidence across the board that your technical skill set is where it needs to be to perform the job you're applying for. But from here, on that same note, as looking for long-term talent that can grow within the firm, senior executives are going to want to know that you can do more than just memorize formulas and input information into a spreadsheet, and they'll want to know how you think through investment decisions and cause and effect scenarios on your own. So in this final round, you might be asked questions around your own personal real estate investment thesis, the macro or microeconomic factors that drive your opinion on a particular product type or geographic market, or what you think the result might be of a changing political climate or new economic policies on the real estate industry as a whole. With technology automating more repetitive tasks than ever, companies are really looking for analyst and associate candidates who can think critically, taking all the data provided in research databases, models, and spreadsheets, and then being able to paint a picture of what that all means and to provide feedback on how that might play into how the company makes investment decisions in the future. Questions like, what do you think will happen to real estate pricing if interest rates rise? Or what does a DCF analysis tell you about an investment? Or what are some things that might cause cap rates to rise in the future? Are all fair game questions at this point in the process to see how you view the industry as a whole and how you think critically about problems without a clear-cut solution. In most cases, there are no right answers to these questions, but being able to articulate a well-thought-out thesis and then being able to use supporting data to back that up will go a very long way in showing senior executives at the firm the kind of thought process you could bring and the value you could bring to the company's decision-making process in the future. So if you're heading into a final round interview in the near future, these are three things that can put you head and shoulders above your competition when talking to senior leadership that's evaluating you for a new role. And if you're looking for more help and personalized guidance to navigate through the job search process, and you also want access to Excel financial modeling courses and practice interview exams that you might run into in a real life real estate interview scenario, make sure to check out Break Into CRE Academy, which is going to give you instant access to over a dozen courses on real estate financial modeling and analysis, Excel case studies and practice exams, and additional one-on-one email-based career support to get your questions answered every step of the way. Also, if you like this video and want to see more career and interview related content on this channel, make sure to hit the like button on the video to let me know. And if you have any final round interview questions you've come across that I missed, let me know in the comments below what those questions were and how you answered them. As always, thanks so much for watching, guys. I hope you found this helpful. If you're heading into the final round of the interview process, good luck, and I'll see you in the next video.